Hey everyone, and I hope you're doing well. Welcome to another ASMR and beer and food video. I think we're up to number 60 something. I can't recall. I'll figure it out once I title the video. I am off the wagon just for a little bit. I'll get into that. I have a brew here, Evil Twin Brewing. Even more Coco Jesus. It is, I'll explain all that as well. I have Nick's original roast beef with cheese, some onion rings, and when I'm done all this eating and drinking, I'll probably drink a little bit while I play this. I have this these gold playing cards with a Benjamin Franklin on them. So we'll get into those. I'm going to play a game of solitaire at the end here. Bag of onion rings. And these are the holy grail of onion rings. Any type of onion ring that's has this kind of batter and the really thick onion rings. Not those onion rings you find at like Burger King. Although I do like those. I will admit, I'll eat anything. I'm a goat. I will eat almost anything unless it has mayonnaise. Except when mayonnaise is in potato salad and coleslaw and the egg. What's that with the egg sliced in half? Deviled egg. I've grown to like those. So I may have to rethink the whole mayo militia thing. So I have some hot peppers, looks like. Some horseradish. I've never really eaten horseradish on anything. Let's put that out of the way. I think these are hot peppers. Now, this is Nick's original roast beef. There's only three locations in the Philadelphia area. One in, I think, South Philly, one in Westchester, and one in Springfield. I'm not a huge roast beef sandwich kind of guy. Never was fond of it. Probably because I'd never really found a place that made them good enough. And as you can see here, this is the reigning, as far as I'm concerned, in my opinion, the reigning king of roast beef sandwiches. All right, so we got some provolone, it's melted on there. And you got this delicious, I think it's slow cooked, roast beef with gravy, a little bit of gravy on there, or the au jus, I'm not really sure. It's some pepper, but it's so tender, and the sandwich is warm. It's delicious. So start here so it doesn't get too much colder. Delicious. The roast beef is so tender. And the provolone cheese is just a great compliment. And you can see how big of a sandwich this is. I'm gonna get to that beer in a second, but let me just get started on this a little bit. Now, I like cocktail sauce, and if I'm not mistaken, horseradish is in cocktail sauce, is it not? Because it smells very similar. I've never really had horseradish sauce by itself. I'm just going to dip my finger in here. It's got a kick to it. You know what? I'm considering putting that on my sandwich. Let's say I get one of those onion rings. Look at that. Nice, crispy, deep fried onion ring. Bad for the heart. But you know what? Everything that tastes wonderful. It's just bad for you. Wouldn't it be great if they could genetically modify everything and take all the bad stuff out of it? Like, for instance, pork, beef, chicken, right? We all kind of agree that, you know, we hate animals having to suffer, right? It'd be great if we could just grow meat, right? We could just let the animals be and figure out a way to grow genetically modified meat blobs. So all the wonderfulness, this perfect meat, it's no high cholesterol, low in sodium, tastes just like meat, real meat, looks just like real meat, but it doesn't come from animals. There you go, right there. All right, anyway. It's a nice tingly onion ring for you. I'm in heaven. I'm a simple man. I don't need a gold watch, gold chains. I don't need a BMW in the driveway. Fancy clothes. Just give me deep fried onion rings so that I can slowly clog my arteries and have a heart attack in my 70s. I love you, little guy. And I love you too. It's important that we let our organs know how much we love them. It's probably why they fail us. Okay. Let's get on to this. Evil Twin Brewing. Even more Coco Jesus. Or even more Coco Jesus. I don't really know how you're supposed to say that. It's 1 pint. It's a imperial stout with maple syrup and coconut added. Two of my other favorite things. And I love coconut. So let's take a look here. In the back we have a little description. It's 12% ABV. So this is got a little bit of a kick to it. A few times in the history of craft beer, a highly praised beer rises beyond mortal stardom into a higher godly league. Usually, the recipe to make such heavenly drops is thick, fudge-like body. Amazingly overwhelming aromas of chocolate, coffee, dark fruits, muscovado sugar, maple syrup, coconut, and obviously only made in limited amounts. People, this is the taste of rare. Brewed by Evil Twin Brewing, Stratford, Connecticut. So as I said, I'm off the wagon for a little bit. As you may have known if you've been listening to my podcast or watching some videos here and there, follow me on social media. Just cracked this open. And let's give this a pour. I'm going to put this down because I have, ladies and gentlemen, beer mic. So I'll just be quiet for a moment while you enjoy those sounds. All right, you'll have to excuse me a moment. I'm trying to see if I can catch the aroma of, you know, the maple syrup and the coconut. Not really. Mostly smell typical stout. That kind of sharp, malty, chocolatey aroma that's typical. Let's give this a taste. Cheers. It's good. A little bit of bitters. This is my favorite kind of brew. I love the Belgian wheats. I love porters and stouts. It's got a really creamy, you know, if you've listened to my beer reviews or tastings in the past, I always use the word creamy. These aren't really beer reviews as much as they are beer tastings. But some bitters, it's creamy, it's thick. Can taste that malty, that just classic stout, malty, dark chocolate flavor. Delicious. Coffee, a little bit. Not a lot of, there's not a lot of carbonation either. All right. I'm gonna top this off. Put this back under beer mic. And I'm going to finish my sandwich. Yeah, I can already feel that 12% ABV. I'm just gonna continue eating here, and then when I'm done, I'll talk a little bit about my quitting alcohol, and then off the wagon a little bit. I don't really taste the coconut or the maple syrup. After the initial wonderful, delicious flavors of the beer, now I'm starting to taste the alcohol. That's how strong it is. It's just on the verge of being one of those beers like that are aged in aged in a hard liquor barrel. I forget how they say it. I reviewed a couple of those brews, and you can really taste the alcohol. And I'm not really too much a fan of hard liquor anymore. I avoid it altogether. I'm not much of a fan of hot peppers. Sweet peppers, I love on my hoagie. That's it. I don't really like the hot stuff. Occasionally, hot peppers in the salad, in a garden salad, and on occasion, like this. I love the flavor. I love the taste. The texture. It's just that hot. It's just the how hot they are, how they burn your mouth. The only thing I don't like. I think I'll scoop some of this horseradish, one of the last remnants of the sandwich. And I figure this stout, strong enough to kind of overpower and, you know, compensate for the kick spiciness, I guess, or how hot it might be. That is delicious, I think. This, in the 45 some years of my existence on this planet, I believe that is the first time I've had horseradish on anything besides being in cocktail sauce, which I think it's in there. I mean, I'm pretty sure, 99% sure. I like it. Takes a little bit away from the just natural flavors, and that's the one thing I don't like. It's a huge burning and distraction from just enjoying the food for what it is, but Occasionally, I can see myself putting that on a sandwich. It's a nice, you know, a nice added layer of flavor. I don't know if there's a Nick's roast beef near where you live, but if not, if you've never had a roast beef sandwich before, try to hunt one down if you can. I don't really know if roast beef, you know, what it's like outside of the United States or in other states. You know, even with the horseradish sauce on this, it's not really overpowering the flavors of the roast beef and cheese. It's actually a nice, almost like separate layer. You can taste it, but it's not overpowering. I'm actually start having to eat horseradish on more things now. I don't know why. I had some weird misconception about it. I don't know if I always thought it was like mayonnaise was in it. But I don't know. Alright, last bite. I'm in heaven, folks. You know, this is all people need. Good food, shelter, clothing, free healthcare, and, you know, access to the tools and the education, you know, for free. I'm never going to stop picturing a utopian society where any child and adult can achieve their happiness without being limited by money. And, you know, it's just ridiculous to me. And that's not the beer talking. Thank you, Beer Mike. You have been very helpful. All right, let's get rid of... Bye-bye, Beer Mike. Thank you. Your contribution was not in vain, or whatever. was it for the sandwich. If you have a Nick's roast beef near where you live, definitely check them out. They have roast beef, they have pork, they have broccoli rabe, which I don't even, or rabe, I don't know how you pronounce that. I don't even know what that is. I know it's broccoli, of course. No, it's broccoli rabe, but it's carrot. It's actually carrot. That's what it's all about. Food, glorious food. Happiness for me isn't about the money. Yes, it's about the money as far as, you know, we need money to be able to do the things that we can that makes us happy, you know, to buy this, to do this, but it's not about accumulating wealth. It's not about this is making me so much, I'm making so much money. For me, it's being able to have enough so that, you know, you can do what makes you happy, or you can pay the bills and you have some money to enjoy some things in life. But the whole material possessions things, I went through that phase. You know, I did that. I never had a gold watch or anything. I leased a brand new Jeep back before YouTube, back in the early 2000s. I went through that middle age crisis in my early 30s. You know, I don't need an empire. I don't need, you know, and it's not saying that because, we're getting down that path again. Talk about this stuff all the time. So, do you like onion rings? I hope so. Because any friend of mine likes onion rings. And not to plug Nick's roast beef, but that's the only place. Hand to Cthulhu. That is the only place that I get roast beef sandwiches from. About some of that horseradish on the onion ring. I wish you could see this, but my beer right now has the eye of Sauron. You probably won't be able to see it, but if I can turn the camera, if you can see that. Right here, it's the Eye of Sauron. It was in the middle, but of course, as I turn this towards the camera, oh, it's like Sauron is reading my thoughts. Yeah, I don't taste the coconut. I mean, maybe very faintly. The maple syrup, there's a slight syrupy texture to it, but it's not like I'm drinking anything that's strong. I think I've had a syrup beer before in the past. Yeah, the alcohol, you know, the strong alcohol content, the malt, that chocolatey, coffee, malty flavor, that really kills whatever kind of coconut. I'm not sure what the coconut does. I'm not sure if it's for flavor or for other purposes, but I'm not a beer expert. All right. That's it for the food. Gonna talk a little bit about why I'm off the wagon, why I stopped drinking for a little bit. I've been drinking off and on. I'm a casual drinker, okay? Ever since I was like 17, and a friend of mine, we broke into his parents' refrigerator. They had a refrigerator in the basement, a second refrigerator. And we took out the vodka, you know, and we drank, we got drunk. So from that point on, every, you know, sometimes it goes several months, a few months, there was either marijuana or alcohol. You know, throughout my 40 years, I've probably had marijuana about a dozen times. Really. Maybe two dozen, between a dozen and two dozen, okay? From my mid-20s up to my 30s, there wasn't any. In my 30s, there was some marijuana about a half a dozen times before the birth of our son. And then I haven't had marijuana since, so it's been like a decade since I've had marijuana. The devil's lettuce. But alcohol, I've had alcohol ever since like I was 17, but I'm very fortunate not to have the type of system where I can become addicted. I quit smoking. I haven't smoked since the early 2000s. So it's been about 15 years since I had a cigarette. Well, that's a lie, because I've had a cigarette occasionally when I've done some videos, Martha, and maybe one other video. But it was around December 2016. And it was just that point where I was kind of tired of having beer. And I just thought, you know what, I'm done drinking alcohol for a while. I didn't like the way it was affecting me anymore after, you know, the days after drinking. Not that I would put in, you know, it wasn't any certain mood. You know, maybe it has always contributed to some of the impatience or anger, but my impatience and my anger, you know, going to 0 to 60 in a second, that dates back even before I had alcohol. So that impatience and that quick temper, that's just a genetic thing, I think. So, December 2016, I thought I would just stop drinking. I'm done. I no longer have an interest in wanting to continue to drink beers. It almost began to feel like a routine, like I was forcing myself. So, month, you know, 1 month after another, and I've been on these streaks before. It's not like every year or every month I've had a beer. I mean, you know, there was times in my 20s, times in my 30s, where I didn't drink alcohol. So it's, you know, going on this drought, going on the wagon isn't anything new for me. But when I started drinking beer on my channel, it was to enjoy the beers, you know, taste them for what, enjoy them for what they are, not to get drunk. It's a huge business, the beer industry, just like the milk industry and the beef industry, you know, it's all about the moolah. But yeah, so I just stopped, and it wasn't until about 2 weeks before the making of this video, we had one last beer. I had a in the pot in the my last podcast prior to this video. I said I had a case of Blue Moon. I didn't have a case. I had a six pack. I misspeak all the time because my brain is just constantly going. My mouth can't keep up. So this takes a lot of effort for me to talk in this manner. I'm not normally like this, so I'm doing it just for you guys. But, I had a six pack of Blue Moon up in the cabinet above the fridge, chucked it. Had one bottle out of it, though, in the fridge in the bottom shelf on the door. And I happened to notice it, and it was just that one moment I was like, you know, I could go for a beer. I could go for that beer taste of the Blue Moon, that wheat beer flavor and all that. So I cracked it open. I had about a half of it. I was like, all right, that was good, and chucked the rest of it. And then about a week after that, I was in a certain situation, and I had two beers, two more wheat beers, I think, and enjoyed that. And I was like, oh, I guess I'm off the wagon now. And I'm not completely off the wagon. I'm still sitting on the back. Just picture one of those old West wagons, maybe no cover, the big wooden spindle wheels. You got the guy up front driving. You know, there's a couple of other folks on the wagon with me. And I'm sitting on the back. I got one hand on the wooden siding, you know, like this. And I'm sitting just like this, and I got my feet dragging in the dirt, and I'm kind of wanting to jump off the wagon completely, you know, as I watch all the alcohol, you know, go by, slowly go by. I just kind of reach out and grab one. So that's where I'm at. I'm just kind of, right now, just want to have a couple beers. Just want to take a break from my abstinence from not having any beer. And I'm just going to do this video and enjoy this beer. And that's going to be it for a while. I don't want to get back into the habit of drinking all the time because it's not good for your brain. Let's just be honest. And, or other parts of your body, it's toxic. But, I love you, brain. I really do. I love you, brain. Sorry. Sorry, I just, a personal moment there between the guy in charge and me. So that's really it, you know. My thoughts about beer are, it probably shouldn't exist. It probably causes a lot more harm than good. All the accidents, the DUIs, the fatal fatalities, what it does to marriages and families and just people and alcoholism. The human race, we are the most interesting, complex conundrum of a species, I think. It's almost like the human race is a freak experiment. Not gone wrong, and not gone right. I mean, you just think about every other animal. Every other life form on the planet seems to have a very predetermined, programmed, excuse me a second, are we done? Thank you. A predetermined, just way of life. They don't have this brain that's somewhat a blessing and a curse. And just take a look around the world, all the things that human beings do, all things we do, that the wonderful things that we're capable of, the art, and going to the moon, and all these things that no other species can do. And then there's the dark side of all that, all the horrific things that we do that no other species does. It's the human race. I mean, what can you say? You know, it's just a circus, you know, and so beer's talking now, I think a little bit. All right. Well, that's it. I hope you get a chance to have a roast beef sandwich, whether it's from Nick's or some other place. Delicious. If you ever get a chance to visit the Philadelphia area or its suburbs, try to find a roast beef. Try to find Nick's roast beef. I'm not here to plug them. I paid for this myself. What do you say we bust open these gold-plated playing cards, and have a little game of solitaire, and then that'll be it. Send you on your way, and hopefully you get a chance to relax and whatnot. All right, so I'm gonna flip the camera down, and we'll play some solitaire. Before we do that, I just want to say thank you for joining me, and I wish you all my best. All right. All right. So we have this gold looking pack of cards, and there is even a certificate. It says certificate of authenticity, gold foil, laboratory test report, gold certificate, 99.9% pure 24 karat gold. So I don't really know. That's just a joke, I find it a little funny. Some nice looking cards, though. I mean, if you ever want to, impress someone or just have something a little different. There's the Joker. Really nice. Jack of spades, clubs, queen of clubs, king of clubs. There's the ace card, really nice there. It says, ace, lord of the clubs. Jack of spades, queen of spades, king of spades, there's the joker. There's the diamond cards, face cards, so. All right, let's get rid of the joker. We had one right back here. And one right there. So we'll just put those aside. We'll just leave them over here just for fun. For kicks. All right, let's shuffle these up. I'm not going to do the flip. I know there's a certain name for that, but just for sound purposes. I'll just shuffle these up a little bit this way. And that humming you hear in the background, if you heard throughout this video, is someone mowing their lawn. I thought I would leave it in just as a little maybe it'll be a kind of a warm, comforting sound to hear. And I can't do too much to get rid of it. There's tripod leg. I got up on top of the table here. You can hear that little textured surface there. I didn't realize how long this video was before I started doing this. Hopefully I can cut down some of the time that I spent talking in the, during the eating parts. As I'll tell you, it doesn't take me an hour to eat. It takes me like 5 minutes. Alright, let's just shuffle these one last time. Do this. Let's cut the deck. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. Let's bring those down a little bit. Because I'll need to leave room for the four stacks of each suit. This is actually the only gold, anything remotely gold, that I own. Oh, what am I doing? Damn. Now I know where everything is, but yeah, I'll forget as the beer continues to run its course. I think I might have messed that up. Yeah, whatever. It's all good. Alright, we don't have anything that can move up top. So I don't have anything here that can get moved onto it. So I have the six here and the seven. Put eight onto the nine. Another king. I can put a queen on one of these kings. Really matters too much where. Okay, we can get the red seven. Over another eight. I got here another eight. I think I'm done. All right, one, two, three. Queen. Seven of clubs on the eight of hearts. Need a jack with a 10. Can't do anything there. One, two, three. Jack of hearts onto a queen of spades. That's it. One, two, three. King of diamonds. Can't do anything with that. One, two, three. Ten of clubs. Can move that onto the red jack of hearts. A three, I need a four. I don't have a four. One, two, three, ten of spades. I would need a red jack of diamonds, but I don't have that. One, two, three, jack of clubs. Put on one of the queens. And that's all I got. Can't do anything else. One, two, three, a 10, put that right there on that blackjack. Got a 9 right here, lift that pile up. I'll put that right here. And I'm gonna do is just move these up here like that, just to save some room here on the table. All right, flip this one over. Three of clubs, can't do anything with that. Jack can't go there unless it was a queen of clubs or spades. Let me just take a look here. I think I'm done. I can't move that anywhere. Can't put that anywhere. All right, let's keep going. One, two, three, four spades. Can't do anything with that. All right, one, two, three. King of hearts. No dice. One, two, three. King of diamonds, no dice. One, two, three. Jack of spades, put it right there. Three of diamonds, I don't have a four. Can't do anything with that. One, two, three. Three of spades, can't do anything with that either. One, two, three. Jack of diamonds, can't do anything with that. One, two, three. Four spades. All right, let's try again. One, two, three. King, one, two, three. Another king, one, two, three. Six, put that on the seven right there. Can move the five of clubs to that six. See what we got under here. Eight of diamonds. I can move a seven there, but or I can put it on a nine. All right, three, I don't have any fours. So I am stuck. All right, one, two, three, two of spades. Can't do anything with that. One, two, three, seven of diamonds. Put that there. And I can put a six here. Jack, can't do anything with Jack. One, two, four. I need a red five for that one. Take one last drink here. All right, one, two, three. King of hearts, can't do anything with that. One, two, three. Another king, two, three. 10. I think we need a red jack. I don't have one. One, two, three. Queen of clubs. Can't do anything with that. Three, four. I'm done. That was a bust. All right. We'll do one last game here. That's good. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. We can spread those out a little bit more. Got enough room here on the table to do that. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, three, four, five. 4, 5, 6, 7, 5, 6, 7, 6, 7, 6. All right, move that ace up there. We got, oh no, we got a 6. Move on to the 5. Flip these cards over. We got a red 5, we can move on to the black 6, flip that card over. Got black 8, move this whole pile right over this 8. Flip this card over. We got a queen. And we are done. And not a bad start. Oh, not done yet. We can move this pile over here. Flip this card over. We have a 9. Move this 8 over to that 9. This leaves a free space for a king. Now we are done. Alright, 1, 2, 3. We got 2 of clubs. Can't do anything. Oh, we can move that over here. We got a 5 of clubs. Can't do anything with that. 1, 2, 3. 6 of diamonds. Can't do anything with a 6 of diamonds. 1, 2, 3. Ace, move that right up top. 10, can't do anything with that. 1, 2, 3. Another 10. 1, 2, 3. A jack, right there in that queen. Another queen, can't do anything with that. 1, 2, 3. 2 of diamonds, there we go, right up top. 3 of diamonds, there we go. Moving right along, king, put that king here, put that queen there, frees up another king spot, and I think we are done. Yep, 1, 2, 3, 9 of clubs, 1, 2, 3, 10 of hearts, put that right there, need a black 9, get that black 9 or that red 10, flip this card over, we got a 2 of hearts. Look at that, move that 2 right up top. Flip this one over, we got a 5 of hearts. And we are done. Yes, we are. 1, 2, 3. 6 of hearts, 6 of spades. Can't do anything with that. 1, 2, 3. 10 of clubs, nope. 1, 2, 3. King, move that king right there. Ah, we have another king. Probably would have been better to put that one there, but c'est la vie. All right, thought we can move that queen. No, we can't. 1, 2, 3. Red queen. 1, 2, 3. 9 of clubs. 1, 2. Last card. 9 of hearts. All right, looks like we're getting down to the nitty gritty. 6 of spades. Kind of stuck there. 1, 2, 3. 10 of clubs. Nope. 1, 2, 3. 10 of spades. 1, 2, 3. 2 of spades. Nope. 1, 2, 3. 7 of clubs. I'll put that right there. 9 of clubs, nope. 9 of hearts, nope. Alright, 1, 2, 3. 6, nope, need a red 6 right there. 1, 2, 3. 10 of clubs, nope. 1, 2, 3. Nope, 1, 2, 3. Nope, 1, 2, 3. And that's it, we're out. Alright, thank you very much again for watching. I hope you found this relaxing and enjoyable. I can't guarantee there's going to be another beer review. Probably not. Probably not for... maybe not this year. But maybe again some other time. Alright, wish you all my best. Stay well. I hope you're happy. I hope you're doing the things that make you happy and... we're trying to. that is it for me. I'm just gonna do another round here, but we're gonna fade out. And hope to see another podcast or another video real soon. Take care. Tingle on. Bye-bye. And we'll just shuffle these as we fade out.